Hey, brothers and sisters, this is your brother Patrick here coming to you by video on demand. I started to say live. Of course, while I'm making it, it's live. When you see it, it's on demand. Hope you guys are doing all right. Praise the living God, brothers and sisters. I just wanted to make a video of something the Lord just dropped on me. I just wanted to talk about something that someone had asked me as it's related to what the Lord was just showing me. You talk about speaking in tongues, and there's speaking in tongues, the gift of tongues that I've been talking about. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, it lists the different gifts. There's 9 categories of gifts, you know, and there's subcategories that it doesn't get into in that list that you will see acted out throughout the Bible, like the book of Acts and so forth. Anyhow, as an example, it says gifts of healing. So, you know, I know people have the gift of healing with people with cancer, and that's basically the way God uses them. They pray for somebody with cancer and they get healed, but they don't, you know, if they pray with someone with diabetes, it's nothing happening. There's other people that prays with people with diabetes and they're healed, and not with people with cancer. So there's gifts of healing and different types of healing. Someone was asking me about praying in the Spirit. And as I mentioned in the video I made yesterday, praying in the Spirit, and I'm not going to read that text right now. If you read 1 Corinthians chapter 12 and chapter 14, and if you do a Google search on the Google, or if you go download eSword, which is free, you can do word searches and stuff and look at these things where it talks about building up your most holy faith, praying in the Spirit. And then Paul tells us that praying in the Spirit is, you know, praying in an unknown language. And even as Paul says, though I pray with tongues of men and angels, 1 Corinthians chapter 13, without love, I'm nothing. So, without charity, as the King James says the word charity, but it's agape, sacrificial love. Anyhow, so someone was asking me about that, and I was discussing that, just to put this out there, as an example, practically how these things work. When we pray in the Spirit, that's our own private prayer language, and it's not the gift of tongues with interpretation in the church. This is our own private prayer. Now, we may do it in the church. Like if you're in a church and they're doing praise and worship, there may be somebody beside you who's doing praise and worship along beside you, and then you hear them speaking in tongues, but they can't be heard, but just like you're right beside them. Not everyone can hear them. Their voice is mixed in with all the other people singing. That's praying in the Spirit. And there's no interpretation required in that situation. Interpretation is required in the church, and it's loud enough for lots of people to hear it, you know, and then it's like everything gets quiet. I've been in churches many times where tongues came forward and someone interpreted. Now myself, by the grace of God, God has used me like 3 times to give a tongue, and then someone else, as a matter of fact, it was the same church, and the pastor's wife, she has the gift of interpretation. And so she got the interpretation. And there's only 3 times that I can think of that the Lord used me for the gift of tongues in a church. And all the times I've seen it happen besides that, the church I used to be an altar worker at, we would have a regular manifestation of 3 or 4 different people out of the church who would speak in tongues. And then some, we had different people who would also interpret. And what would happen is, you know, because God is orchestrating that, someone would begin to speak in tongues loudly, and then the music would die down. The worship leader would, you know, just be led by the Lord for him to be quiet and have the, you know, the music die down, and then the tongues would come forward, and then someone would interpret. And then the pastor of the church that we had, as an Assemblies of God church, he would get up in the middle of praise and, you know, in the praise and worship and say, you know, this is from the Lord, or, you know, and there was never a time when he said it wasn't, but he knew the people were speaking in tongues. He knew the people were giving interpretation. And he would say, this is from the Lord. And he would, and sometimes it's usually in the church, the Bible tells us it's an exhortation. The gift of tongues is for exhorting the church. And so with interpretation or a prophecy that comes forward, sometimes we had a prophecy come forward without tongues and interpretation, but a straight up prophecy. Same thing, tongues with interpretation, same thing as a prophecy by itself. And then the pastor would stand up and say, hey, this is from the Lord. And lots of times it's a call to repentance or, you know, the church needs to wake up and be on fire. Those kind of things. It's usually kind of what the Lord is saying to his people. And so the pastor would get up there and say, hey, this is from the Lord. I know in my spirit from the Lord. The Lord spoke to me. This is from him. So, you know, let's everybody come down to the altar. The Lord is telling me, you know, everybody come on down or whatever, you know, a call to action in line with what was given. Now, praying in the spirit is something different. And as I mentioned, Paul says it's a mystery and we should pray for interpretation. And I was just, you know, I had commented to this brother, and I just wanted to say it on here because I think I mentioned this before. When you have praying in the Spirit, as an example, I prayed with thousands of people. And lots of times when I'm praying with them one-on-one, I'll begin to speak in tongues. And sometimes I'll get a word from the Lord or I'll see a vision from the Lord and I'll tell them. And then it's word of wisdom, word of knowledge, and all that kind of stuff. There's sometimes where the Lord won't tell me. But even though, because I'm a pastor and I'm in the prophetic ministry, lots of times the Lord will tell me, but he won't tell everybody, even though it doesn't always. But so as an example, I could be praying with somebody, and this has happened to me a few times, 3 or 4 or 5, 10 times, I don't know, many times, because I've prayed with so many people over the last 15 years as a pastor. The Lord would, you know, would have me praying in the spirit. This person is, you know, a secret homosexual. Now, the way God operates, he doesn't try to embarrass people, but there are times he will, if the person will be caused to repent by being exposed, that's what God's going to do. I mean, God is the judge. God knows the beginning from the end. God knows all things. So as an example, I just use that one. Let's say that there's a man who secretly, he's married, like that pastor of the church with those funny looking lips. Always knew something was wrong with that guy. The guy that came out, he was doing drugs and having gay sex and all this. He had a great big mega church, I think, in Colorado, and he's got these big old funny effeminate lips. I forgot his name now. You know, him and his wife, you know, he's reconciled. You know, him and his wife, he's supposed to have worked it out. He's supposed to have repented. He had to step down from the ministry out there in Colorado, I think it was. And I just never liked the guy because of the way he moved his mouth when he's talking. Now I know why, I guess. But anyway, because he's a little, got sugar in his pants, as they say. But anyway, brothers and sisters, as an example, you know, he got exposed after how many years of him sneaking and doing that stuff. Okay? And I've dealt with pastors and other people, the same kind of a thing. The first thing the Lord does is, like, if I would pray with somebody like that, the Lord would say, hey, go pray with this this person, especially if it's a pastor, but anybody. And then you would pray in the Spirit, and you wouldn't know what you were praying, but by the power of the Holy Spirit speaking through you, a mystery, you're interceding for that person to repent and that they'll stop it, you know, without you knowing what you're praying about and without any of the public knowing what they're praying about. As an example, you go pray with a man and wife, and then the guy is cheating on his wife or with a gay or with a woman, or he's doing drugs or whatever, and his wife doesn't know it. It's not, you know, God is the judge. He wasn't necessarily exposed that man in front of his wife or his family or his friends or whatever, because the result would be the guy's going to, you know, leave his wife and run away and never repent and go to hell. You know, so God knows that. Now, that's not always true, but let's just say that would be the outcome with lots of people. So the Lord would use some other form step by step to bring that person to repentance. First, by someone interceding for them in tongues and not knowing it. Then they almost get caught. You know, then they have a scare that they thought they if there was drugs, they almost overdosed on drugs, or they almost got busted by the police, or, you know, and God would just step by step bring this person, you know, we're talking about especially Christians or a person whose spouse is a Christian who's praying for them a lot, you know, God will put the squeeze on them. And one of those things I'm saying is where praying in the Spirit comes out to be used by God, where we're praying a mystery so that that person will not be exposed until the time, if they continue to be in an unrepentant state and continue to be in an unrepentant state for on and on and on, there's a point where God will, boom, hey, they're going to get caught, you know, they're going to get caught red-handed in their homosexuality or their drugs or their affair with another woman or whatever it is. God will take it to that point if that's what it takes for them to repent. And that's how God operates, brothers and sisters. Anyway, I want to cut off this video. I got another video of something that the Lord just showed me, just in line with what I'm talking about. Let me cut it off.